Hello everyone, this is Jean-Michaël. This is our first video from our series on multimedia APIs with Qt. In this video, we'll focus on Qt Multimedia. Qt Multimedia is a library that has been shipped with Qt since Qt 4 era. About licensing or things like that, it will still be available under LGPL, GPL, and commercial license. Qt Multimedia provides various capabilities, for instance, audio playback, video playback, camera playback, playing simple sound effects, but also handling playlists, and most of the things you need to actually write a media player, for instance. We'll first look at various documentation and examples from the Qt website. It is, as usual, of very good quality. The Qt Multimedia documentation presents both the Qt widgets and the QML implementation. Most of the capabilities of Qt Multimedia are available through these both programming languages. Let's look at the various classes. There are all the audio classes, the camera classes, the media playlist things, and the high-level media players, the sound effects, and video things. A very important thing here is the various kind of APIs that Qt Multimedia provides. There are both low-level and high-level APIs. Low-level meaning that you can, for instance, access the individual pixels of a video frame to process it, for instance, with OpenCV or something like that. And high-level means that you have some classes where you just pass a video file URL and it plays it for you. Now let's have a look at the QML classes. The QML types are very straightforward to use, for instance, to play audio or audio input or audio output, to stream video, to get access to your webcam's feed, that kind of thing. For instance, let's have a look at camera. It is extremely simple, even so it provides a lot of various APIs. But the common usage is just creating a camera object and setting the few properties that are of interest to us. Something to know about Qt Multimedia is that, unlike some other non-Qt APIs, it will use your operating system's codec. This has both good and bad side effects. The good side effects are that your users, if they are used, for instance, to using, let's say, QuickTime or Windows Media Player on Windows, it will play back basically the same because it will use the same operating system APIs behind. The bad point is that they may sometimes need to install codecs. For instance, as of today, Windows still doesn't ship H265 codecs, and you have to install additional codecs to play back that kind of file. And Qt Multimedia will suffer from the same limit. So if you know that you are going to need access to various codecs and you want to be able to play back any kind of file on any computer, Qt Multimedia is not the correct solution. We invite you to check our first half videos for other libraries that allow you to do that more easily, but with other drawbacks. On Linux, you may need also to install GStreamer codecs to access the full range of codecs offered by Qt Multimedia. Now, let's check some examples. The main example we are going to look at is QML Video FX. It is a very simple QML example, yet very powerful. It allows to apply shader-based filters on your camera's feed. So let's look at the code. QML Video FX has mostly QML files. This is what interests us. So we have all these effects, embossing, blah, 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 which are mostly shaders. And what interests us are the content things, because that's what is going to be processed, and that's the Qt Multimedia API. You can check here the import statement, import Qt Multimedia, and the Qt Multimedia objects. Here, media player and video output for the video, and a very simple camera object for the camera feed. Let's have a look at how it plays. Here we launch it, and let's just start our camera, and that's myself. Now I can apply some filters on it, for instance, black and white, and just move the slider like this. As you can see, it is extremely efficient in terms of performance because it uses the GPU. And the code used to do that is extremely simple. So what else can we say about Qt Multimedia? This is a QML example. We won't check the widget examples too much in depth, but they are quite similar if you want to do the same kind of operation. One thing, however, to keep in mind is the API model of QtMultimedia for audio, for instance. QtMultimedia tries to use the same abstraction than file-based input outputs, QIO device for audio input and audio output. This sometimes leads to some complications when you are used to simple pool model used by Port Audio and that kind of library. RT Audio does the same. So if you are looking to do some simple audio input or output, you just want a buffer of audio samples to play back, you just want to set, let's say, 512 values in the buffer to write audio, QtMultimedia is not that straightforward to use. So that is it for this video. We hope that this has entertained you, and please stay tuned for our next video, which will be on VLC and VLC Qt, which is also an API that you can use from Qt.